the man who first competed way back in 1984.
Half past six on an overcast summer morning, and Olympic race walker Chris Maddocks has already completed three circuits of the city's Central Park. The path to his fifth Olympic Games has been a hard one, and in what is not a high-profile sport, often a lonely one too. Chris has already set a record for these Games as the first British track and field athlete ever to compete in five Olympics. As the only British representative in his chosen sport, he's looking forward to flying the flag for his country yet again.
I'm the only British male qualifier in the walking events. That's 20 and 50 kilometres. There were six places available. Rather disappointingly, I'm the only guy to have reached the Olympic standard. We've got one female qualifier in the 20 kilometres, and Lisa Keeler is a great friend of mine, so I'm really pleased about that. If I fly the flag for Britain and for British race walking, then that's something that I'm fairly comfortable with. I would like to have more company there, but if I have to carry the mantle of British race walking, then I'll do that. It's something that is very important to me, and I'm very proud of.
Chris, these are your fifth Olympics. You must be incredibly proud.
Yes, I am. It's been a long and relatively successful career. It's my fifth Olympics that I'm selected for and the sixth one in consecutive years that I've qualified for.
Which one didn't you go to then?
I actually qualified, I'm almost embarrassed to say it, but for the Moscow Olympics, but unfortunately I didn't get selected then. So this is 20 years at Olympic level for me.
You work in the vets. How do you find that?
Well, I've always grown up with lots of animals around me. My mum has always encouraged us to have a lot of pets. So when I go home, there's always lots of cats and dogs around, rabbits, guinea pigs, ponies, that sort of thing. So it, I suppose there was something inevitable about me ending up working at a veterinary surgery. I only work there as a part-time veterinary helper, but it's something I've done for quite a few years. I have Edmund Shillaby, who's the local veterinary surgeon, and he's one of my best friends. He will be there in Sydney supporting me, as he often is, with his wife Barbara. And people like that who have been there with me virtually all these past 20 years, that means an awful lot to me. The fact that he's my employer is of secondary importance. It's more that he's my friend that will mean more to me than anything else.
The Games have changed dramatically over the years that Chris Maddocks has been competing in them. As he prepares for his last taste of Olympic competition, Chris can be said to epitomise the true spirit of the Games. It's not necessarily the winning, it's the taking part.
And we'll be meeting some more of our Olympic hopefuls next week. Plymouth's Chris Maddocks became an Olympic favourite last night when he finished last in the 50-kilometre walk. He came into Stadium Australia 1 hour and 10 minutes after the winner to a standing ovation from the crowd.
Chris Maddocks knew he didn't feel right when he started the race. For weeks now, he's been suffering with a hamstring injury, but he was determined to compete and in doing so make history in being the only track and field athlete to take part in five Olympic Games. He came into the stadium half an hour behind the walker in front of him and finished in 39th place in a time of 4:52.12. But what a reception.
Contested four previous Olympic Games and six World Cups. He's got the course finished, and that is absolutely magnificent.
Just so grateful for all my friends and fans out there who kept me going, because I so desperately wanted to stop. I was hurting so much. But God, that reception at the end, it was out of this world.
17 athletes failed to finish the 50k course in the humid conditions, so Chris Maddocks did well to keep going. Although he came last, he must surely feel he's leaving the sport on a high.
Well, we can now rejoin Hamish in Sydney. Hamish, that was some achievement, wasn't it?
Well, the reception was absolutely fantastic. I can hardly describe it. There was 90,000 people in the Olympic Stadium behind me. And remember, Chris had come in almost half an hour behind the person in 38th place, who was the guy in front of him. Chris had had to stop a couple of times through pain, but the crowd gave him an absolutely standing ovation. It's something I think he'll remember for the rest of his life, I'm sure he will. And they realised what a torture he was going through just to come into the stadium. He was in pain, he was suffering, but he was such a proud man, such a proud Olympian, that there was no way he was going to let that stop him from having his moment in the sun. The crowd here took Eric the Eel to their hearts on the first week, and I think it's not unfair to say that Chris Maddocks is joining him in that great stage of Olympians who've played their part in Sydney, just showing that it's not all about winning.
Marvellous. Now, can Kate Allen...